I am Amit and I welcome all of you to our YouTube channel MBAEC. We are discussing CAT 2020 question. This is a slot 3 question. Question is on CISI, a very simple question. Kehta hai, a person invested a certain amount of money at 10% annual interest rate. So I know my annual interest rate is 10%. So my rate of interest is 10% per annum. ठीक है? But साथ में ये भी कह रहा है compounded half yearly. So the compounding period is half year. So we have to be careful about that. Compounded half year. So it is compounded half year. All right. फिर कहता है after 1.5 years. So the time period is given. Time period is how much? 1.5 years. So in 1.5 years, how many compounding would happen? Compounding happens every 6 months. So in 6 months, there is one compounding. So in 1 year, there will be 2 compounding. In 1.5 year, there will be 3 compounding. So I know number of compounding will be 3. And the interest rate in the compounding period, so you can also say that interest rate in compounding period will be 10/2, that is 5%. Why? Because in 1 year the interest rate is 10%. My compounding period is 6 months. So 1 year, 10%. So 6 months, half of that is 5%. So you can use the formula and say if my principal is P and there are 3 compounding at 5% compounding rate in the compounding period, so it will be 1 + 5/100 to the power 3. This will be my cumulative amount at the end of 1.5 years. We can directly use the formula, and this is given as 18522. So from here you can find out the principal as 18522 divided by 1.05 to the power 3, and you'll find this is 16000. So the answer is 16,000. Now 1.05 to the power 3, you cannot do it manually, it become too much time consuming. So you will have to take help from the calculator which is given in the exam. So you'll have an on-screen calculator. You can use calculator in such cases. But I have also emphasized a lot in my previous few videos when we had discussed the percentage basics, that wherever possible, try to treat percentage as fractions. If you do it that way, then your calculation will simplify. This is again one very good example of a question where you don't have to take help from the calculator if you deal percentages in fractions. Let us see how we can go about solving this question without using calculator by dealing percentages as fraction. Let's say my principal is P. So in my interest in the first 6 months will be 5%, so will be P/20. My interest in the next 6 months, I know from the chart, it will be this P/20 plus 20 plus 5% of this. So 5% is 1/20 of this. 1/20 is how much? P/400. If you have known the basics of CI, you will understand this. So I'm presuming you already know the basics. Then in the last 6 months, it will be this interest, the previous interest, that is P/20 plus P/400, and 1/20th, that is 5% of the previous interest, 5% of this. So 5% of this is 1/20 of P/20, that is P/400, and 1/20 of P/400, that is P/8000, right? So my overall cumulative amount will be sum of all of this. All of this put together will give you cumulative amount. It will be P plus P/20, P/20, P/20. So this is 3 P/20. Then P/400, P/400, P/400. So this is 3 P/400. And you have P/8000. So P/8000. And this total is given as 18522. It may seem very complicated to you why to do this if there is a calculator present, perfectly all right. But had there been no calculator, how would you have done it? The calculator is given you in one exam CAT. It may not be available in other MBA entrance examinations. So in those cases, this method will help you. So what we can do now, we can multiply both the sides by 8000. Okay, so let us multiply this side by 8000 and this side also by 8000. So you have 8000 P plus 8000 से ये कितनी बार जाएगा, 40 times 40 into 30, this is 120 plus 400 से कितनी बार जाएगा, 20 times 20 into 3 is how much, 60 and plus 1 times P is 18522 into 8000. If you add this, you'll find this is 1200, right? So you have 9261 P is equal to 18522 into 8000. 9261 से 18522 कितनी बार जाएगा, 2 times. So P is 8000 into 2, कितना आ जाएगा, 16000. So there is hardly any calculation. I mean, these cannot be classified as calculation. You are just simplifying it. You are doing calculation only at the last two steps. That's all. So as you can see, if you deal percentages in fractions, many of the question becomes a lot simple in terms of the calculation that you have to do. I hope you have understood the idea here also. Both the methods can be adopted here. But if there is no calculator, the later method that we discussed will be more appropriate. Thank you. Thank you guys. Thank you for watching.